sorry, we've got to take that out. It would, you'd eliminate that from your budget, and you'd have more money left over.
Okay.
I lost my voice. Could you clarify for me? I'm a little confused on what we should do with the car. I know in the beginning we talked about keeping a $5,000 car, but at the end we talked about maybe keeping the Silverado that we have. Could you expand on what recommendation you would like us to do with the second car?
We recommend fixing up your Chevy Silverado.
Thank you.
That's okay.
Because while you could buy another car for $5,000, it's more reliable to fix up a car for another $5,000 instead of a used car, which could come up with more problems. And a new transmission is more reliable in the long run.
Yeah, so that was just one of our recommendations that you could do, depending on what you feel would be more trustworthy, because we don't know all of the stuff that's going on with your car. So if you feel that it would take more to try to repair your car than to try to find one maybe in a $5,000 budget and see what kind of repairs you can make to that kind of car, if it would be cheaper. Those are just two of our main recommendations.
And to clarify for the beginning slide for the car, we tried to say that it should be around $5,000.
Okay. Thank you.
And then, so the $20,000 for a down payment on a house, where am I getting that from in my budget? Where do I have $20,000?
Oh, where you have it? So some of it could come from the traditional IRA that you have, and then the other part, oh, hold on, let me think. There was the leftover money, but there's also, for the year, the leftover money that you have that year, that is your current budget, that $13,000, and then you could pull some from the IRA, that should amount to that, if you, and your tax refund of $2,000.
Yeah, so it would just kind of be an accumulation of all of the money that you would be getting back and being able to save.
Okay. So to understand your recommendation on the IRA that we inherited, are you suggesting that we should liquidate that IRA all in the first year, or how should we take money from that?
Well, we know that it's, I'm pretty sure there's a rule that says that you have to take it out within 10 years.
Yeah, so you have to take out your IRA within 10 years because you're not the spouse of the person that passed away. So we do recommend that within the first year you try to take it out, just to try to put it towards the thing that you need. We know that you're going to get heavily taxed for it, but that's just kind of the easiest plan that you can go with for right now.
Also put it into your health savings account, because Alex, you talked about having a retirement plan, which you can also use for that if you don't use it all.
So if I put it in a health spending account and I don't spend all the health spending account, I get it at the end of the year?
Not at the end of the year. So you would, in your mind, keep that you have that much amount in that account, and you would not use it until you're retired. And then that's like tax-free, and that has many benefits.
You know, we're in our 20s, and a lot of these decisions seem so big and so far off. How important really is it that we start doing all this right now in our 20s versus waiting maybe till our 30s or 40s?
Well, right, and so that there's a lot of this stuff that you can wait till then, things such as, if we bring back up the main points, things such as the inheritance, we want you to take it out now because of the 10-year thing to try to just get that out of the way. Alex needs a car. But something like Ridley's Future, maybe that can wait a little bit more. If you guys feel that you can save up enough money to put in and create a savings account for her later in her life, or like a house, you don't need that right now because you already have a current living situation. That was one of our recommendations too, was maybe wait like 12 months or maybe even longer if you guys feel that you want to wait longer. Maybe at that point the roof will leak, they'll fix it for you. You don't have to pay that $1,200, fixing.
But it's also important to start with a house sooner, because property is also always a good investment and can always grow to more money, which will be helpful in the future. And you can pass it on to Ridley when she grows of age.
All right, thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
Thank you.